عليكم boys and girls, رمضان مبارك. Welcome to ICOI story time. I'm really glad to be again with you this year, and I'm really excited to tell you that this year inshallah we will be talking about Prophet Ibrahim. Who's Prophet Ibrahim and why we were talking about it, about him? Because Prophet Ibrahim is the father of the prophets. He had so many prophets and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him that Prophet Muhammad descend from him. Sayyidina Ibrahim was the one who built the Kaaba, and he's the one who called us al-Muslimin, and this is a great honor for us to belong to Prophet Ibrahim as well. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mentioned him so many times in the Quran. He have mentioned his life since he was a little kid until he became one of Allah's great prophets, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him Khalilullah. Khalilullah means Allah's best friend, which means that Prophet Ibrahim is a very, very, very great prophet that we are so proud that we descend to him. And we, our ummah was called Muslimin by Prophet Ibrahim. What is his story? To begin with, he was born in a city called Al-Iraq. And in this country, Al-Iraq, he was born in a little city where people used to worship idols. They didn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They only believed in their big idols. And even Prophet Ibrahim's dad, Azar, he used to build idols with his hands and sell them to people while they take them home and worship them. When Prophet Ibrahim grew up, he was looking at them and he was wondering, how come they are worshiping something that can't help them? How come they are worshiping idols that can't grant them anything? He was a very smart kid, so he started to ask his dad, how are you doing it? How are you worshiping something that you are building with your own hands? How can you ask him to give you something while you are the one who just built him? His dad was furious and he said, Ibrahim, this is what I believe in, this is what my parents used to believe in, and you can never change that. Prophet Ibrahim's dad lived and died believing in idols, and lived and died building idols with his own hands. But Prophet Ibrahim had a very different path. So he kept wondering, how can these beautiful skies been built? How these mountains, the water, the plants, everything around him, this has to be built by a great God, not just the idols. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved Prophet Ibrahim so much that Allah wanted to show him signs. So Prophet Ibrahim one night was looking at the sky and he saw a twinkle, bright star. Prophet Ibrahim says, this is my God. It looked wonderful. It was really shiny. And he said, maybe this is my God. He kept looking at him and he told everyone, hey, this is my God. I believe in him. And then by the time the star went away, he couldn't see it. Prophet Ibrahim said, this can never be my God. My God would never leave me. This cannot be the God. Then he saw the full moon and he said, oh, this is my God then. This big full moon should be my God. He's in the sky. It looks powerful. And I believe in it. When the sun came, when the night passed away and the sun came, he said, this could never be my God. How can the moon be my God while it just left me alone? And he looked at the sun and he said, this is bigger. This is brighter. This is my God. And then when the night came and the sun went away, he said, this could never be my God. God would never leave me alone. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him that he looked everywhere around him and he said, Allah has to be my God. Allah would never leave me alone. Allah is the mighty, powerful one. He can see me. He can feel me. He can create everything around me and he would never leave me alone. And so he told everyone, I believe in God and only Him. I don't believe in your idols. I don't believe in your stars. I don't believe in your moon. I don't believe in your sun. I only believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then a mighty king showed up in Iraq. His name was An-Namrud. An-Namrud used to call himself God. He used to say, I am the most capable God. I can do anything I want. So Prophet Ibrahim asked him, so can you bring dead people to life again? And so he said, yeah, I can kill people and I can keep someone alive. So I can do that. I can grant them their lives and I can end someone else's life. So Prophet Ibrahim told him, then can you bring the sun from the west instead of the east? And then An-Namrud wasn't able to respond. He wasn't able to answer because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who can move the sun, who can move the skies, who can build the skies and move anything. If Allah wants to, He's the most capable. So An-Namrud couldn't answer. And he was very angry at Prophet Ibrahim and he wanted him to leave his country. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was very powerful with the truth. He knew that he believed in the right God. He knew that he believes in the right thing and he knew that people around him are wrong and he is right. He wanted to prove it to them. He wanted to show them a live proof, but they didn't want to listen to him. So Prophet Ibrahim had a very smart idea. What is the idea? And what is he going to do with his people? This is what we're gonna tell next time, inshallah. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope that you look around you and you look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation and draw a beautiful drawing and share it with us about whatever you like and whatever you cherish from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. And inshallah, see you next week. Assalamu alaikum.